Hello friends, I am Sushant Raghavan. Welcome to the technical and quality section for understanding the technical requirement in and quality standards in the clothing industry, making a sustainable garment. I have good practical experience in the apparel manufacturing sector. My skills are CAD pattern making, sample development, technical requirements, and measuring quality performance. Today's session is about cutting requirements in the garment manufacturing industry. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Now let's begin the presentation. Technical requirements in cutting. The first stage in the manufacture of garments is the cutting of materials into the necessary pattern shapes. When a large quantities of garment style must be cut, a lay is formed which consists of many piles of fabric spread one above the other. From this must then be cut all the garment pieces for all the sizes which it has been planned to cut from the lay. The pattern shapes for the garments may be drawn on a paper marker placed on top of the lay, or information as to the shape and positions may be held within a computer to be plotted similarly on a paper marker or used to drive an automatic cutter. A marker plan is made in which the pattern pieces are closely interlocked to achieve minimum fabric usage. The requirements of marker planning. The industry has always paid great attention to marker planning, because when the cutting room cuts cloth, it spends around half the company's turnover. Any reduction in the amount of cloth used per garment leads to increased profit. The planner will try a number of pattern placements, selecting the one which gives the shortest marker. The work of the marker planner is subject to number of constraints. Pattern alignment in relation to the grain of the fabric. The grain line should lie parallel to the line of the warp in a woven fabric or the veil in a knitted fabric. Marker 1, pattern placed with the pattern grain line on the warp. Where pattern pieces are laid across, the grain line should lie parallel to the weft or coast direction. Marker 2, pattern placed in the pattern grain line on the weft. The nature of the fabric. Symmetry and asymmetry. Many fabrics can be turned around 180 degree and retain the same appearance, and these are designated either way or symmetrical. More restricting are fabrics known as one way, either way, or asymmetrical. In this case, if a fabric ply is turned around, it does not retain the same appearance. Examples of such fabrics are those with a nap or pile which is brushed in one direction, knitted fabrics where the loops of the veils always point in the same direction, and fabric with a surface design which does not run the same way when turned around, but where either design is acceptable. Even more restricting are fabrics which are one way only. The desired result in the finished garment. The design characteristics of the finished garment. For example, if a vertical stripe does not show a complete mirror image repeat, the right and left side of a garment may be designed to be mirror images of each other. In this case, a marker is planned which uses a half set of patterns, and the required effect is created in the spreading of the fabric which places pairs of plies face to face. The matching requirements in finished garments. Generally in stripes and check fabric, there are many matching requirements in garments. The marker planner needs to consider the blocking of pattern pieces, block buffer, and matching points. The requirements of quality in cutting. For the majority of cutting situations where a knife blade is used, the placement of pattern pieces in the marker must give freedom of knife movement and not restrict the path of knife so that it leads to inaccurate cutting. A pattern count must always be made at the completion of the planning of a marker to check that the complete menu of patterns has been included. Correct labeling of cut garment parts is essential. If in shorting and bundling a multi-size lay after cutting, operators are to identify correctly the parts which make up the whole garment sizes. The requirements of production planning. When an order is placed for quantity of garments, it normally specifies a quantity of each size and color. The buyer often gives a ratio. The marker planner needs to plan the best lay ratio and length for that particular order. Efficiency of the marker plan. The marker planner measures its success by the efficiency of the marker plan created. Since the reduction in fabric cost is so important, the company expects the planner to discover opportunities for improvement in marker efficiency by suggesting alteration to patterns and fabric width. The requirements of the spreading processes. Shade sorting of cloth pieces. It is likely that cloth pieces that are normally the same color will have been dyed separately and are not an exact shade match. When delivering a number of rolls of cloth of the same color is received, they should be sorted into batches such that shade differences between them are undetectable. Where rolls of cloth of same color but different shades do have to be spread, they are separated by a layer of interleaving paper which can be seen easily at the edge of each cut stack, which assist in easy separation of the plies for bundling. Lays containing more than one color are spread with the colors changing from one roll to the next to make bundling easy. Correct ply direction and adequate lay stability. These two factors must be considered together as the opportunities for achieving them are related. They depend on fabric type, pattern shape and the spreading equipment that is available. If fabric is being spread by hand or if a spreading machine with a turntable is available, there are four possible types of spread which can be achieved. Combining the two directional possibilities with the face up, face down and face to face possibilities. For symmetrical pattern pieces and fabric which is stable, spread face to face. For asymmetrical as well as symmetrical pattern pieces and fabric which is stable, spread all the same way up. The fabric can be spread along and immediately back again, but the roll must be turned on a turntable before returning. For asymmetrical as well as symmetrical pattern pieces and fabric which is stable, all the same way up, the spreader spreads in one direction only and deadheads back to the spread the next ply in the same direction. For symmetrical pattern pieces and fabric which is stable face to face, the spreader spreads in one direction only, but after deadheading back, a turntable is required to rotate the roll before the next ply is spread in the same direction. The requirements of the spreading processes. Alignment of piles. Every ply should comprise at least the length and width of the marker plan, but should have the minimum possible extra outside those measurements. The surplus width is usually distributed outside the edge of the marker plan furthest from the spreading operator by aligning the straight edges of the plies nearest the operator. Alternatively, plies are centered and the surplus distributed equally to both edges. Inaccuracy in this alignment could mean that plies do not cover the whole area of the marker plan and parts of some pattern pieces could be missing when cut. The requirements of the spreading process. Correct ply tension. If the plies are spread with too loose a tension, they will lie in ridges with irregular fullness. If plies are spread in a stressed state, they will maintain their tension while held in the lay, but will contract after, thus shrinking the cut parts to a smaller size than the pattern pieces. In a non-stretched fabric, particularly, all elongation of the fabric occurs in such a manner that rapid relaxation recovery ensues. Thus, the use of spreading machines with positive feed to give tension-free spreading normally removes stretch plies being bound into the lay. In addition to the tension which may be produced by a conventional spreading machine, there are likely to be tension inherent in the fabric roll. These elements of stretch do not allow rapid relaxation and recovery. Hence, stretch fabric plies are commonly positioned by hand, and although the fabric may be dispensed from a traveling spreader, it may be required to unroll and allow to relax overnight before spreading. The requirements of the spreading processes. Elimination of fabric faults. Fabric faults, flaws, holes, stains, etc. may be identified by the fabric supplier, and additional faults may be detected during examination of the fabric by the garment manufacturer prior to spreading. In either situation, a string or plastic tag is attached to the fabric edge level with the fault. It is possible that the spreading operator may also discover faults missed in previous examinations. The simplest way to achieve this is by creating a splice. The spreader cuts across the ply at the position of the fault and pulls back the cut end to overlap as far back as the next splice mark. Splice marks are marked on the edge of the spreading table prior to spreading by reference to the marker and ensure that whenever a splice is created, the overlap of fabric is sufficient to allow complete garment parts. If more time is available, it may be possible to consider the position of a small fault in relation to the marker and move the ply so that the fault occurs in a waste area. Other option is to add a fabric patch of sufficient size over the flaw so that a separate recutting is avoided later. A frequent fabric fault which can apply to complete piece of woven fabric is tight selvages, which causes fullness in each ply in the central area of the spread. It must be corrected by cutting into the selvage to release the tightness. The requirements of spreading processes. Elimination of static electricity. In spreading plies of fabric containing man-made fibers, friction may increase the charge of static electricity in the fabric. The spreading operator will experience difficulty in laying a ply neatly on top of the others owing to either the attraction or repulsion of those plies according to how they are charged. He cannot align the plies accurately nor create a compact spread. Friction may be reduced by changing the method of threading the fabric through the guide bars of spreading machine. Humidity in the atmosphere of the cutting room may also be increased, thus allowing the static electricity to discharge continuously to the atmosphere. Avoidance of distortion in the spread. A layer of glazed paper laid glazed side down is normally placed at the bottom of the spread. This helps to avoid disturbing the lowest plies of material in the spread when the base plate of a straight knife passes underneath, and also gives stability to the lay if it is to be moved on a flotation table. In addition, it prevents snagging of the fabric on the table surface, which often becomes roughened with use. The requirements of the spreading processes. Avoidance of fusion of piles during cutting. Cut edges of thermoplastic fiber fabrics may fuse together during cutting if the cutting knife becomes hot as a result of friction with the fabric. In this case, anti-fusion paper may be used in the same way as interleaving paper. It contains a lubricant which lubricates the knife blade as it passes through the spread, thus reducing the increase in temperature of the blade arising from friction. The objective of spreading is to place the number of plies of fabric that the production planning process has dictated to the length of the marker plan in the colors required, correctly aligned as to the length and width and without tension. The spreading of multi-size lays of many plies demands strongly constructed tables, usually the steel legs and braced frames, a heavy laminated smooth wood top and sometimes center legs. A 10 meter lay of shirting fabric with 200 plies can weigh up to 600 kgs, and with 150 cm wide fabric can exert a downward pressure of up to approximately 40 kg per square meter on the table surface. The table may also bear the weight of the spreading machine traveling on steel rails at the edge of the table. The type of table surface is critical for the spreading and cutting operation. The objective of cutting. The objective of cutting is to separate fabric parts as replica of pattern pieces in the marker plan. In achieving this objective, certain requirements must be fulfilled. Precision of cut. Garments cannot be assembled satisfactorily and they may not fit body correctly if they have not been accurately to the pattern shape. The ease with which accuracy is achieved depends on the method of cutting employed and in some cases on the marker planning and the marker making. In manual cutting using a knife, accuracy of cut given good line definition depends on appropriate well-maintained cutting knives and on the skills and motivation of the cutter. In both die cutting and computer control cutting, the achievement of accuracy comes from the equipment. Clean edges. The raw edge of the fabric should not show fraying or snagging. Such defects come from an imperfectly sharpened knife. The objective of cutting. Unsauced or unfused edges. The buildup of heat in the knife blade comes from the friction of the blade passing through the fabric. This in extreme cases leads to swatching of the fabric and more frequently to the fusing of the raw edges of thermoplastic fiber fabrics such as those containing polyamide or polyester. The cutter cannot separate individually plies from the pile of cut parts. Force separation causes snagged edges. Solution to this problem lie in a well sharpened blade, a blade with wavy edge, and use of anti-fusion paper during spreading. Spraying the blade with air coolant lubricant, slowing down the speed of the blade and reducing the height of the lay. Support of the lay. The cutting system must provide the means not only to support the fabric but also to allow the blade to penetrate the lowest ply of a spread and sever all the fibers. Consistent cutting. The cutting system should not be limited in the height of plies it will cut because of progressive deterioration in cutting quality through there may be mechanical or human reason such as toppling or leaning for the height of lay being limited. Thank you for watching. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Please comment your valuable thoughts and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified when I post a new presentation. Bye, have a good day.